Here are the 7 ways I'm using AI
to become a hacker.
Now, why AI? Because I don't have time. You see, I just made the mistake of committing publicly to get the Hack the Box CPTS certification, a pretty rigorous hacking cert. I thought this was gonna be easy, but no, it's one of the harder ones. Look at this time estimate, 43 days. That's 43 full days, meaning over 1,000 hours to complete this sucker. I don't have time for that. I've got a business, I've got 6 kids, so that's why AI. Now, I know many of you are like, gross, AI? And I get that. And I did a poll on LinkedIn, Twitter, and YouTube. That's kind of split. And I get the hesitation. But let me tell you, I've been trying AI with my study routine. It's crazy. And many of you gave me some advice, and I started using it. Oh my goodness. Number 5 is killer. Like, you have to start using this. Anyways, get your coffee ready. Let's dive in. The first way I use AI to study is to help me develop a study plan. And this involves 2 steps. First, I'll open up a note in my favorite notes application, Notion, the sponsor of this video. I use Notion for everything, from taking notes to running my business. You'll see why here in a second. Now, on this fresh note, I'll compile everything there is to know about the certification I'm studying for, starting with my whys, like why the junk am I doing this? This is an important step, don't skip this. If you don't have a big enough why, you're not gonna be consistent. I've got a few of them. And you may wanna use AI to refine your whys. Maybe give you some more ideas. So you would copy and paste your whys into your favorite AI LLM. Or if you're a Notion AI user like me, you can do it all right here. They've got ChatGPT baked right in. I can just type in space and go, hey, refine my whys. And it writes it for me right in here. And you know what? I like the additional whys. It's pretty stinking good. I'll just take out my old ones. Although I don't care about this one. I've already got a job. Now, Notion itself is free. You should definitely use it. It's amazing. Notion AI is an add-on for only 10 bucks a month, which is definitely worth it. Now, if you already have Notion AI, you may already have access to Notion Q&A, which is amazing. Now, Notion Q&A is still in beta. So if you don't have access just yet, you can request access as long as you are a Notion AI subscriber. I got all the info below. Whys are in place. Now, let's get some info about the certification. I'll just go to their website, and this is just a copy and paste game. Grab all the info and paste it right in here. I'm gonna turn this into a toggle so I can collapse it. And then I'll add in some more things like how long it might take, how many modules and sections it has, and then how much time I have, how busy am I, and how many hours can I devote to study each week. And with all my information compiled, I can then copy and paste this into my favorite LLM or Notion AI right stink in here. And let it go to work. Coffee break. They're saying it's gonna take 115 weeks and they've outlined a plan for me. Might need some tweaking, but this is a pretty good start. Now, one more fun thing I do for my whys is I'll use AI to remind me of why I'm doing this based on my whys. With Notion AI, I can create what's called a custom AI block and paste what I want it to do, the prompt, inside the block. And with this generate button, it'll do what I tell it to do, which is picking one of my whys at random and encouraging me. If I click it again, it'll pick a new one. Just a nice little thing to come in and get inspired. Because motivation will do this. But if your whys are strong and you keep yourself encouraged, you can get past that and stay steady. The second way I use AI to study hacking is to check my knowledge before I dive into a lesson. So let's say I'm working on the network enumeration with NMAP module, and I just happen to be in the firewall and IDS IPS evasion lesson, which just sounds awesome. To see if I could skip this, what I'll do is just go in here and just copy everything about this lesson and paste it into my favorite LLM, or in my case, I'll just put it right in my notes in Notion. Now, I've got a pretty crazy way of managing my notes for the CPTS. It's my study tracker. If you want to know more, let me know in the comments below. But anyways, I've got a special note for this very section, and then I'll paste all that information in the content section and then ask AI to test me. So your prompt might look like this. Now, this is a fairly new feature with Notion. It's Notion Q&A, an AI assistant. I can just hit Control J to launch it. There it is. And I might use a prompt like this, giving it a persona and telling it to quiz me. Let's do this. Oh wait, I gotta specify the page. I can do that with an @, and it'll just pull up the firewall and IDS IPS evasion page and reference that. Now, what's cool about that is that it's not just pulling random information from the internet. It's looking at the content I have and curated here in my Notion environment. And here we go, it's gonna quiz me. And I'll just blaze through this real quick. So tell me if I'm right and then clarify and then move on to the next question. This is so killer. How crazy is this study session? I'm kind of giving it dumb answers, a few right answers, and I want to see what it does. But think about this. You're essentially approaching an expert hacker and saying, hey, let me know if I can skip this course. Test me. That's what we're doing right now. Now, AI is not perfect. It answered the question for me. Just prompt it again. And that's kind of how you have to approach AI, like most things in life, with a grain of salt. And then I'll ask it to evaluate me based on my performance and tell me if I can skip this. Okay, it told me I shouldn't skip it. Let me ask it what I should focus on. And I'll ask it for a study plan based on my weaknesses. And it did this weird daily plan, but it did tell me what to focus on, which is pretty sick. I'm sure if I revised my prompt a little bit, did some prompt engineering, I could get this dialed in. Number three, summaries. This is a superpower. The ability to take a ton of notes that both you take or from the source material and ask AI to summarize it for you is insane. It's great for just initially getting a feel for what you're about to learn. And it's also great for review. When you're looking back over your notes, you don't have to read through a bunch of chicken scratch or nonsensical stuff maybe you typed. Just get a quick few bullet points. And this is what I have built into my little template here. I've got this prompt, which again, you can paste and use in your own LLM. I've got it in a custom AI box inside Notion. And based on the content here, I'll just click generate. And I told it to make a 5-bullet-point summary of what this lesson's about. What's also cool with Notion is you can have an AI database field or table field that will auto update. So up here in this little database, I can just say, hey, look at the content of this document and create a little summary for me. So why that's cool is as I'm looking through my database here of stuff, I got a bird's eye view of what a certain lesson might be about. And I can update that whenever I need to in case the content changed. Now you don't need a fancy prompt to summarize things as you're taking notes. Like with a Notion, I can just go space and choose one of the options like, hey, summarize the sucker. And it'll do it for me right here. And it's just part of my notes. I love that. Anything to remove friction as you're studying and save you time. Number four is probably my favorite. I use AI to study hacking to help me get a deeper understanding of what I'm looking at. And I do that in a few ways. First, I'll create a mind map. I've got this prompt. And based on the content of my page, I'll just launch this, generate. Mind maps are cool because they organize the content of a lesson visually, the way the brain might process it. It makes it easier to see relationships and hierarchies amongst concepts. It's amazing. I'll also use AI to pinpoint the most important things about my lesson in my notes, and then let me know if there's any more context or any additional information I need to master this skill, to broaden my understanding. So here's my prompt, and I'll just generate, and it gives me everything I need right here inside my notes. Again, you can do the same thing with ChatGPT or Claude or Gemini, pick your poison. But how killer is this? It's insane. I'll also do concept comparisons with this prompt, and check out what this does. This is really fun. It'll compare IDS and IPS in a table. A SYN scan versus an ACK scan, decoy versus DNS proxying. By contrasting these topics and technologies, we can more easily understand what's going on. Also, what I like to do is a common pitfall prompt. And what it'll do is check and see like when students typically study IDS and IPS or hackers learn this, what are common pitfalls they might encounter? What are mistakes they make that I should avoid? AI, tell me. And then with a few of these prompts, like my practical applications, I can make this whole lesson more real world. Like when would I use a SYN scan? When would I use an ACK scan? Give me some real stuff. Give me some case studies. When were these techniques used to do something legitimate or illegitimate if it was like a hack? But it'll produce these for me. Now again, AI, grain of salt. But how cool is this? And then I have one more called Deep Dive, which does what it says. It does a deep dive. It breaks down the topics into smaller, manageable parts and has in-depth explanations. Let's try it out. This stuff is just crazy. And it's taken me just a few button clicks to generate this stuff for myself. Now, one last bonus thing. AI can help you more deeply understand something by explaining it to you simply. Because sometimes there's not enough coffee in the world to understand some things. So for example, on this content, I can take all this, copy it, or ask it right in here, and say, explain this to me like I'm 5. Actually, 5 is too young. Let's say I'm a 3rd grader. And I'll just insert that right here. Being able to break down concepts like that without having to Google around and search forever is amazing. And then beyond that, just taking that idea and chatting with the AI. So for example, chatting with Notion AI here or Notion Q&A, and you can start to have a conversation to break down an idea even more. So for example, it mentions deep packet inspection. I may not know what that is and go, hey, what is deep packet inspection? And notice what's cool about Notion Q&A is that it's gonna prioritize my documentation and my notes. It'll even tell you that sometimes it didn't find what it needed to find in your notes and it pulled it from AI knowledge. And then finally, one more with the deep dive. I have an analogy generator. I'm a big fan of analogies. They really help you understand some things. So I'll ask it to create analogies for the topics in this lesson. Let's try it out. A SYN scan is like knocking on a door to see if someone is home, but leaving before they can open the door completely. It checks if the door can be opened without actually entering. That's not bad. And this does two things for you. First, if the analogy is on point, it helps you understand it. Second, if the analogy is kind of like, well, you're critically thinking on if that actually applies and you're learning in the process. That's awesome. Sorry, too much coffee. Let's just see where we go. Oh yeah. Number 5 is my stinking favorite. Talk it out. This one is probably the most powerful and will actually test to see if you understand what you're learning. So check this out. Let's do this right now. I'm gonna go grab the content here and paste that into ChatGPT. Now this will be unique to ChatGPT. And I'm gonna tell it, hey, I'm gonna talk to you on my iPhone. Don't do anything with this just yet. Okay, cool, it's in there. I'm gonna open up the ChatGPT app on my iPhone. And with ChatGPT 4.0, I'm gonna jump into a conversation, a voice conversation. Hey, I need to see if I know everything about this lesson. So what I wanna do is have you quiz me, ask me thoughtful questions about the content I just gave you, and then evaluate how I do.
Sounds good, Chuck. Let's get started. First question. One, explain the difference between a firewall and an IDS IPS system. How does each function in a network?
Okay, so a firewall is like a barrier to a network, and an IDS.
Great job. You've got the basic idea down. A few things to fine tune. Firewalls primarily block or allow traffic based on predefined rules.
I mean, do you see how powerful that is to just have a conversation like that and you have to express your ideas in a very, I'm saying this as I'm trying to express an idea. You have to be able to explain yourself and teach it. Now, I used to do this all the time when I would make YouTube videos, not AI, this is before. When I would try to make sure I was explaining a topic simply, I would test it out on my family and friends. Like I would, my wife went crazy because I'd try to explain subnetting to her or what a VLAN was. And I'm like, did you understand that? Was it simple? And maybe it was, but she just didn't care about the information. But I can have a conversation with AI and it can tell me how I'm doing, if I'm explaining it well and what I'm missing. That is so incredible. And just think about this. You can do this hands-free while you're driving in the car. I saw a post on LinkedIn. This is who I got the idea from. A woman named Keturah responded to me and said that she would copy and paste her practice questions for her exams, and then in the car would have a conversation with ChatGPT, and ChatGPT would quiz her, give her more insights. How killer is that? If you're not gonna use AI for anything, for any kind of study, at least use it for this. You can have it quiz you on any kind of content, whether it's a YouTube video and you just put the transcript in there, or it's your notes or notes from a lesson. Having that type of conversation to test you, to use that kind of Feynman technique, if you can't explain it simply, you don't know it, that is the secret. That's amazing. And it's gonna 10X your study. Number six, review questions and flashcards. This one's pretty self-explanatory. For review questions, here's the prompt I use, and generate these bad boys. And notice they're not multiple choice. So I could just launch a Notion Q&A and say, quiz me on the questions in this document, or paste them into your favorite LLM, or have a conversation, do it in the car, subway, whatever. Flashcards are killer too, but I hate making flashcards. So with this prompt, I have AI pinpoint the things I need to memorize, I need to learn to become a successful hacker and to pass the CPTS exam, and I have it generate them for me. So here we have a simple front and back. Sometimes I do like to have these at the table, so I can just highlight these real quick. And ask AI, can you make these this into a table? And it just does it for me real quick. That's seriously so cool. And I do recommend taking these flashcards and putting them into Anki, an amazing flashcard program, and it uses spaced repetition, which will maximize your study time. And finally, number seven. This one is really fun because I'm a big believer in taking what you learn and instantly teaching someone about it, sharing that knowledge. And you can use AI to help you create. And there is no greater way to learn something very deeply and to make sure you understand it than by teaching it, sharing it. And that's the fastest way to figure out if you truly understand something. So here in my template, I've got a content generator prompt. I'll have all my prompts in the description below. And tell you what, I'll also have this as a template in Notion you can use. But anyways, the point of this is to generate content ideas based on this lesson. It's not generating the content itself, because I want to make that. It's giving me ideas for YouTube videos. Like, these are actually pretty good ideas. I've got short recommendations, Twitter post, LinkedIn post. And then of course you can use AI to help you generate that content, but do it in an authentic way. And what I mean is use AI to make you better and help you figure things out faster, but still make the content yourself. And what that means for me is I usually will start typing out my ideas in a very rough format and then ask AI to correct my grammar or fill in any gaps or just to tell me if I'm saying something stupid or wrong. And think about that. That for most people is the biggest barrier to creating and sharing what they're learning. They're afraid of making mistakes, which is a real fear, and I get that. But if you use AI to check you, come on, where's the fear at then? Just do it, create stuff. Now that's the seven ways, but there's two bonus ways I wanna show you real quick. There was one I didn't show you in my template here. It's my cheat sheet generator. This one's sick. I'll have this as a prompt below. I'll just generate this really quickly and it's gonna make a cheat sheet. So like for Nmap, it'll be a bunch of commands, which is awesome. Now also one thing I didn't point out is once we generated, like we've generated a lot of content, like we have review questions, we have flashcards and case studies. We can go up here and have our summary be regenerated based on the added content we have there. Same thing for our little database entry here. The final way I use AI to study hacking, and really anything, is as a second brain. And really, the AI itself is not my second brain. Notion's my second brain. If you're not familiar with this concept, it's a concept of just taking notes on all your stuff. So for example, as I'm learning hacking, I'm taking notes. When I create YouTube videos, I create scripts and I put that all into my second brain. Second, because I don't remember all that stuff in my primary brain, I go to my second brain and look in there. But check this out. AI, in the current day and age, it's getting smarter. But for me, all I care about is what information the AI has access to. Most of the knowledge a common AI has is public knowledge, generic knowledge. I am more interested in an AI that has access to my knowledge, the notes I've accumulated, the things I do. And that's where Notion AI comes into play and their Notion Q&A AI assistant. Because this sucker has access to everything I have in Notion. And not just what I'm studying and hacking, it has access to everything I've been doing in Notion forever, including my business stuff. So I can say, hey, summarize my notes on firewalls and IPS IDS. And it will search across my knowledge base, my thoughts, not some generic blog post that it was trained on. No, it's my stuff. And notice even here, like it shows what document it pulled it from. It gives like references. I can say, did I talk about firewalls anywhere else? Like in my video scripts. And it shows me all the places that I've mentioned firewalls before. And do you see that? I was gonna not talk about that, but here it is. I've connected my Slack organization to Notion AI and Notion Q&A, and it can dig through all my Slack stuff too. Like, that's so cool. I can also do things like this. What was the last script that Alex worked on? I'm specifying one of my employees. It shows me the recent scripts he's worked on. It shows the conversations we've had about that script. The information AI has access to will unlock a ton of stuff for you. And as you're going through your studying or hacking journey, compiling all the information you're learning into a second brain that can then be accessed by AI, that's killer. I'm so excited to use this kind of stuff and see how it advances. That's all I got. I'll catch you guys in the next video.